Hi, I'm Valder Beebe, and I host the Valder Beebe Show on FM radio and internet television. I am famously known for That Celebrity Interview, which I conduct by cell phone, in studio, or satellite media tours. Go to ValderBeebeShow.com, YouTube.com/ValderBeebeShow, or our partnership network with Business in the Black, which is BlackSuccessAcademy.com. And click on the Valder Beebe Show channel. I'll see you there.
Good morning and welcome, Cheryl Nelson. Thank you for joining me here live on KKBI FM Radio on the Valder Beebe Show. We're so excited to speak with you about severe weather preparedness. Now, we're in Dallas, Texas, and you know about the weather in Texas.
Oh, yes, definitely. Glad to be here. How are you today?
I am so well. You know, we just had a bout of really, really bad weather. It's beautiful now, but in probably like most states, it can turn in a minute. How do we have this preparedness that you know about?
Yeah, there's a lot of things that you have to do to prepare for any type of storm, whether it be a thunderstorm, tornado, flood, or even a hurricane. And what we're doing today is we're talking about hurricane preparedness. It is National Hurricane Preparedness Week, and hurricane season officially starts on June 1st. And it's something that you want to be prepared for no matter what, because keep in mind that where you are too, we do have the threat of winds and inland area flooding. Now, remember back last year, we had Hurricane Matthew. Over a million people were left without power. So that could happen again this year, whether it be an active season or a quiet one. It only takes one storm.
It only takes one storm. You are so correct. So what type of things should we do now to be prepared for a storm or a hurricane?
Yeah, good question. For long-term planning, you really want to focus on what you can do to kind of help yourself if there's a power outage. You could be without power for hours, days, or even weeks. And what I recommend is having a standby generator. Like this one right here, it's the Cummins Quiet Connect series. And what's great about this, it's quiet and it's compact, so it's not going to annoy your neighbors. It's installed by a professional and it turns on the second the power goes off, and it stays on for the duration of the power outage as well. And also you can program it. So maybe you want to power your whole house or maybe just some necessities like your refrigerator and some lights. And if you like smartphone technology, there's an app for this too to monitor and control your generator from home. Another thing to think about is flood insurance. Find out if you live in a flood zone. Remember, if you do, there was a 30-day wait period. So it's not something you want to wait until you see a storm coming to invest in flood insurance. Think about that now.
Cheryl Nelson is a disaster preparedness expert and a meteorologist, and today we're talking about being prepared for severe weather. Cheryl, let me ask you, as a storm approaches, you know, the weather meteorologists have gotten so good about telling us what the weather is, but so as it approaches, what should we be doing to be prepared?
Yeah, as that storm is approaching, you want to take some last-minute preparations. Hopefully, you already have a disaster kit and some things that you need in that kit. And these are things you can do now as well. Have a bag to put everything in. Have water, at least 1 gallon per person for at least 3 days. You want to have non-perishable foods like canned goods or granola bars. Also, a NOAA weather radio to get weather information. You cannot always rely on your smartphone. A first aid kit, a flashlight, and some batteries. You want a flash drive to store important documents and information. You want cash, medications, and also think about your pets too. Think about your kids and your pets. Have toys for the kids and for the pets, have toys, a carrier for them, medical records, vaccinations. And if you don't have a microchip or a collar, hopefully you do, it's also good to have a picture of you and your pet together to prove ownership if you ever get separated.
Great tips. Where can my audience go online and find out this disaster preparedness information put together so that they can follow it?
They can go to homegenerators.cummins.com for more information.
Cheryl Nelson, thank you so very much, because this information is so critical to every state in the United States, which we broadcast to. Thank you very much.
Thank you.